The Yaris is Toyota's subcompact car that's focused on affordability and fuel economy. It's pretty boring to look at, but it does the job right. It doesn't have to be boring though. Case in point, the Yaris SE. The name of the game when it comes to the 2012 Yaris is practicality. We're also talking about fuel economy. This car is good for 30 miles per gallon in the city, 38 miles per gallon on the highway, and that's all helped by this wedge shape. It works a little bit for aerodynamics, but not too much. This isn't a slippery fish like the Prius. It's also a little bit on the bland side. This is your basic commuter car. Located under the hood here, we have a 1.5-liter four-cylinder engine. It's paired with either a 5-speed manual gearbox or a 4-speed automatic. The 5-speed's a little bit cheaper, less than $1,000. With this engine, you're getting some horsepower, you're getting some torque. It actually does make some power, some torque. But the real star here is its fuel economy, 38 miles per gallon on the highway all day long. Nice bonus feature, especially in the subcompact segment, is having keyless options. Back here on the back of this 5-door hatchback, just push the button, lift it up, and you're good to go. You've got a little bit of room back here. You can also pop the seats forward on both sides, fold them down, put more stuff back here. This is great for your kids' first car. They can throw their college backpacks in here, all their textbooks, their snowboards, their one or two bags of ramen noodles that they're gonna buy. There's enough room for it to fit back here. It's a small car, but it's got a decent amount of space. Most subcompacts are affordable cars, and the Yaris is no exception. Starting price is in the mid to low teens, and they climb to the high teens. This car, though, what's not afforded is rear seat room. This seat's all the way back. I've got some space. This isn't actually that terrible. I am a little bit comfortable, but the armrest over here is digging into my leg. My head isn't hitting the roof, but it's close. It's acceptable back here. It's not comfortable. Despite being a more affordable member of the Toyota family, they haven't skimped on all the interior options. You've got this cool giant radio system, which pairs with your phone so you can do hands-free calling. You've also got HD radio and satellite, as well as a USB port. On top of that, there's plenty of room up here for the driver. There may not be so much back there, but you're more important up here anyway. Tons of headroom, tons of legroom. I don't even need to push the seat all the way back. You've got the dials for the HVAC within easy reach, and the transmission here with the cool leatherette touch feeling is down here. Looks good, feels good. You've got your cup holders. It's all within easy reach. You've got tons of display room in front of you in terms of your visibility looking forward. Going backwards, you can see over your shoulders, which is good. This is a safe car on the road thanks to all the visibility. Plenty of greenhouse space in here. There's no surprises here. We're not dealing with an exciting car. The steering is not that responsive. There's not much going on with the 1.5-liter engine under the hood. It's actually surprisingly comfortable for a car in its class, which is nice, and all the features are good. But we're not dealing with a sports car here. The SE version would be a little more fun to drive. Plus, with that manual gearbox, you can get a little bit more out of the engine than you can with this 4-speed unit. But that's not what the Yaris is about. This is an affordable car. It's very practical. It's a great first car. On top of that, the fuel economy pushes it through the roof when you're thinking about buying one. It's a car in the mid-teens that gets nearly 40 miles per gallon on the highway is an excellent idea, and Toyota just continues to refine this car further and further. The ride feels better than Yaris's from recent memory. The driving experience is, like we said, it's not exciting, but there's enough there where you're not going to fall asleep behind the wheel, and that's just good for safety reasons. The one thing the Yaris doesn't have going for it is a nice evolution. That's because the competition continues to step up its game with offerings from Ford, Hyundai, Kia, all offering seriously top-notch amenities for a car of this class at a wonderful price point and at the same levels of fuel economy. Toyota needs to add something to step the Yaris and have it stand out from the rest of the group. It's not quite there yet. It's not a bad car. It's fine. It's just the rest of the competition is stepping up its game at a much faster rate.